I have built the entire highly scalable cloud-native machining system for demand forecasting that can train over 1,000 of models in a matter of minutes, even with my MacBook M1. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how it works. Please note that in this demo, I use Docker Compose, but you can also find cloud-native Kubernetes and Helm chart in my GitHub repo. Without further ado, let's get started. First of all, after you have spun up the system, there will be a data producer pushing the latest 5 months of data from this Kafka dataset to Postgres and keep publishing the mockup data stream to a Kafka topic every 10 seconds. To confirm that this action has successfully executed, you can access PG admin service and from the Postgres database Spark underscore PG underscore DB, we can do a quick query. You can notice that on the topmost or latest low, the date is yesterday, because as of the day of recording, I'm recording on 4th of April, and the latest day on the table here is 3rd of April. This is intentional, because I want to mimic as little and smooth data stream as possible. And you might ask, why not today? Because today's data is streaming from a Kafka topic. And to check that, you can access the Kafka UI. And from this UI, you can navigate on the left side, click on topics, and you can see that there is one topic named Sale Lost Man Store. There's quite a lot of messages already because I have spun up the Docker Compose a while ago. If I refresh, you can see the number keep going up because it's set to send the message every 10 seconds. Now that works, I want to go to MLflow UI because this is all the main execution happens. And if I filter DAX by my name, we have two main DAX here, one for the daily and one for weekly. I want to focus on the weekly one first, then come back later on a daily one because they're gonna win smoother. If I click the DAX and see the code on the top, but sorry, on the bottommost. What this DAX does is that it will trigger the training, and it will do that by pulling the latest 4 months of data backward from today or the trigger day. Then it will train all the model on this, and it's gonna do the batch prediction by posting to the forecast service, and it will save the forecast result to Postgres DB. Now I want to manually trigger this DAX so that we can see how it works. You can click the button here to trigger and click the graph. So see latest status. Now the first one, we're gonna call the training service, and it's done quite quickly because all it's done is just posting to a service. And then this task is to keep checking the status of the current training, and you can see that it submitted training job like this, and got status updating running. Now we can see the training progress on the layer UI by going to the lay dashboard service at this part. Now you're gonna see one running job, training job here, and if you click that, you're going to see the training jobs executing here, which is train around 1,100 models at the same time, and it's keep running. So usually this take around 10 minutes on my MacBook, and you can see that log under here. Our training progress are also tracked by MLflow, and you can see the log that for each module it gonna train and create a new version and register them to MLflow, and we can verify that it's working by going to MLflow service on part 5050, and you're gonna see a lot of training experiment starting and finishing here. And if you go to modules here, you're gonna see that there are many models with version 1 here. If that's not enough, you can go to Grafana to monitor your system, how much the dose is taking, by going to dashboard, and you can see whether it's not exposed here, the dashboard. Here it shows your main machine, how many LAM it is currently using, what is the CPU uses, and you can see all the graph here. Or you can also see the CatWises dashboard, which is show the container uses on your machine, like CPU, memory uses, and cache, whatever. Now that the system currently looking fine, let's wait until this training task done, and we're gonna see what's up next.
1 eternity later.
This took a lot longer than usual. It might be because I'm recording the video, but it's almost done here. So give it a second. It should be done pretty soon.
2000 years later.
Now it's done. It took around 20 minutes in my case. So if you have a better PC, it's gonna be a lot faster. Or if you're landing on the cloud with higher spec machines, it's gonna be pretty much faster. I can also look at the metrics on the Lay dashboard itself. This is an embedded dashboard from Grafana. And if I look at some graph, you're gonna see that I'm pretty much hitting my CPU limit all the time. Like this one is using 6 cores of them, because that's how much I allocated for Docker. The CPU utilization is 100% all the time during training. So yeah, that's it for the training. So let's get back to the main DAX here. Now it's done, it's continue on the list of the step. So we're gonna build the request body and posting to the forecasting service to obtain the best prediction of the next week, the upcoming 7 days. And usually this gonna take around not over 2 minutes. It's gonna be pretty fast. Looks like it's done. And if I look at the log from the Docker logs in the terminal, you're gonna see in the last line, you're gonna say that making a prediction for number of entry here, which is mass over number of models, and it took almost 200 seconds. Again, this took longer than usual. Usually it's around 70 seconds in my case, but yeah, that's totally fine. And if I look at the next, the final status is end up with success. Yes. And the last one, you see, the task name is save forecast to DB. Internally, it saved all the batch prediction to the database. And to confirm that it saved successfully, we can use pgadmin again. And if I come into the same database, spark underscore pg underscore DB, and I refresh here, you're gonna see a new table called forecast result. And let's take a quick look at that. And here you go, you got the forecast result, forecast cell here. And I also included lower CI and upper CI for visualization. They also keep track of the model name, the model version. And you might notice that there are negative numbers for cell, which is not supposed to happen for the cell forecast. And that is because the models are pretty bad. Because the accuracy, the performance of the model is not the main focus for this project, but yeah, it's work. Let's focus on the system itself, okay? Now that we already have our batch prediction result ready for the next 7 days, we can navigate to our main web UI, which you don't need to put any port after the localhost, because it is proxy by Nginx and it will got redirected to the corresponding service behind the scenes. And when you come here, you're gonna see we have two input boxes. So we have store ID here and product name. For the product name in this project, I already have one product, but I added it in because I want to make it extensible. So if you have other products in your real project, you can just have another value in the same column name, and it's gonna work correctly as it should. Now, let's pick some random number, maybe 1000 here. And I can press enter after I input here, and you're gonna see the forecast list of the latest, sorry, of the next 7 days from now. If I point to this point, you're gonna see this, the date is 5th of April, and this is 6th, 7th, and so on for the latest 7 days in the database. And basically that is the next 7 days again. And on the subtitle of the line chart here, it includes the model name, and by naming convention, I have put the store ID and followed by the product ID. And another point is the version number here. Now, with the fact that the batch prediction is made weekly, meaning that during the next week, whether it's on Monday or Wednesday, when users come in into this web page, they're gonna see the exact same line chart here as you see here. But somehow during the week, if the users feel like the prediction here is out of sync, outdated, what they can do is they can trigger the lead chaining by clicking a button below here. But before that, I want to go back to our airflow and show you another DAX that I have left up. And if I come back here, I go to DAX here, again, put my name in here. And this is the DAX that we left off in the first place. And the whole purpose of this DAX is to consume all the messages from the Kafka topic and process them with Spark Streaming and append this new process data. Technically, it's 2-day data, and append to our main table in the Postgres. Now, let's click in and manually trigger the LUN. I want you to remember the number. If I can type quick enough, you can see the number of total load here is about, I don't know, about 160,000, right? And if you look at the number of current messages here in this topic, it's around 2,000. So if this works correctly, after this DAX complete, you should see this number plus the number you're currently seeing from the Kafka topic here. Now let's make it done. Okay, let's confirm the result by going to the pgadmin and let's rerun this query again. And yeah, look like it's allowed that number. At least the number go up and I think the number is correct. So now let's go back to our main pain point. With the fact that we already have our daily data sit into our database ready to use. Now, our main pain point that I left off back then is that somehow during the week, the forecast list of the prediction is not quite accurate and it's like outdated. So with the fact that we ingest the data from Kafka daily, so if we click the lead chain button here, you're gonna lead chain a new model for this specific store ID and product. And this is gonna pull the latest 4 months of data, including 2 days data that we have just finished ingesting into our database. And it's gonna trigger the lead chaining to lay. And after it's done, you can check the status that is enough with success. And then you can see the section that say make a forecast for next day using the latest model possible. Let's say I'm gonna click 5 and click forecast. Then it will call, make a call to forecasting service to pull the latest model and do the prediction of the next 5 days that I have input here. And here are the graph that you see. And to confirm that this is the new version, you can look at the subtitle of the line chart here. The model name is exactly the same, because by convention is the store ID and the product name. But the version here is now 2. And if you come back to the top, it's version 1. And you can make another request on how many requests you would like. And you can make a prediction. Again, the accuracy of the model is not the main focus for this project. let's forget on a system. And if I go to MLflow and I want to check for the number of store 1000, and you can see that the latest version is version 2. And if you look at the register at the date, and it's just like just a moment ago that we click a button from the UI. And yeah, we already see the batch prediction in action with the whole system. And we have this UI built with Streamline here, which looks really pleasing. And we have a delete training loop that even user can click a button to retrain a specific model and make prediction based on that. And yeah, that's it for this system. And again, for reminder, there is also a cloud native version of this system built with Kubernetes and Helm a while ago. It is tested on GCP and have included a GitHub action CI/CD to automatically build and push images to Docker Hub and GCP artifact registry. All the details and step-by-step instructions are already on GitHub README, so be sure to check them out. And that's it. And if you like this video, please like and subscribe. Or if you find this project helpful, you can share this video with your friends. And I'm gonna see you next time. Bye.